I'm here with Peter Little, who has been campaigning against the tyranny, doing miraculous work, has also faced his fair share of corruption, being recently arrested. How are you managing?
I'm exhausted actually today because I've been walking around with everybody. It's been an amazing day. Extraordinary. Never seen so many people. It was just wall to wall all along St Kilda Road. Just kept coming and coming and coming. But yeah, it was a bit of a shock on Monday when the police, you know, when we didn't lock down, they attacked Steve-O there with the flag real quick. They gave him no notice and he was down on the ground. I thought, he's taken one for the team. And I had the Shane Tuck ball signed, you know, Shane's suicide of doing lockdown 20th of July. And this ball was donated to me when I found out about him being no longer with us, and he had his wedding at my joint 2007. And so I just let it have the police, you know, on a discussion. I got a bit emotional, but a discussion about the real epidemic we've got, which is mental health. We've got a massive mental health epidemic. We've got a massive suicide epidemic. We've got a massive epidemic of tests of a fake PCR that gives virtually nobody got this COVID. But the real issue is the mental health. And I did get worked up. I don't apologise for that. Very close to Shane when he's playing football. And then 2 days later, Michael Tuck's finally come out, and this was in The Age, 2 days later, and he said that the night before Shane suicided, and I know how he did it, and it wasn't nice, Shane went up to his dad, Hawthorn legend Michael Tuck. He played 426 games for Hawthorn, 7 premierships, 4 as captain after 34, played to 41, and he actually played 70-odd games in the Rezzies. Anyway, Shane's gone up to him, give him a hug, and his dad sort of sensed something. He said, I said to him, don't do anything stupid. And that was the last time he saw Shane.
Yes, an AFL legend. And suicide rates, anxiety and depression are absolutely off the charts. People don't see a future left. They haven't got the strength to combat the tyranny. So they're looking for a way out. And this is devastating. And we see the police, they're not using any discretion whatsoever, targeting the elderly. We've got grandmothers, grandparents, children that are witnessing this. It's downright outrageous, and the reputation of the police force is tarnished. Would you agree?
Well, it's not quite beyond repair, but if they keep this up, I mean, we'll get 100,000 next time. I mean, we've got about 10 today, and if we can get Gary Ablett Sr., who's did a brilliant YouTube on this, Gary Ablett Sr., Shane's uncle, he lost his daughter in 2017 to suicide. His brother Jeff, who played a stack of games for Hawthorn, won 2 AFL spins. He lost his son to suicide, Ryan, 2008. So you've got Shane's mum, Faye Ablett, and her 2 brothers. All 3 have lost a child to suicide, and Travis, younger brother of Shane, nearly suicide, found in a coma, tested 3 times positive, a first AFL player, so he nearly went as well. And I mean, this is out of control, and it's disgusting our population at once if these morons and monsters keep running the show, and we're going to keep stepping up. And I don't know how many times we get arrested, we're batting for the people, and the people came out today, and I went live on Instagram for the first time ever on Peter Little 1955, get a plug in there, yeah. And I hope we save it properly, because I stuffed up saving the one on when I got arrested. That would have been a good one. But the absolute support today, off the charts. It's over. It's over. We're past the critical mass. And people like yourself and myself and Trina here and lots of others have been on the front line for a long time doing it hard. We're not giving up now. I mean, we feel turbocharged. And I got Shane's ball that he signed with 8 legends at the North Melbourne Grand Final breakfast 4 years ago. And I want to get them out. Lee Matthews, Peter Hudson, Terry Wallace, his coach of Richmond. Trent Cotchin, yep, won 3 premierships for Richmond. We've also got Jason Dunstall, kicked 1 million goals. Merv Hughes, the cricketer, you know, just got into the Hall of Fame. And who else have we got? Dermot Brereton, he could run
absolute through. Legends.
We're all there. Imagine if we're all there.
We need more, exactly. We need more people stepping forward, calling this out for what it is. It's really extreme, very tumultuous times, and they are relentless, driving people down into the depths of despair. What would be your advice to someone battling through this and they have lost all hope for the future?
Come out and walk, because it energises you. I mean, gives you confidence, gives you hope that we're getting somewhere. You've got to come out next time. It's a great feeling. It'll keep you going, and you'll meet a lot of people like-minded. You may have been ostracised by your family and friends, but you've got a massive community here to look after you, whatever happens. So I'm so excited about today. It's over. It's over. It's just a question of when, and the great work that's been done by so many people, it's just extraordinary. And we're coming together now, aren't we, like no
we
before.
Certainly are.
And there's a big political political move, and Monica's talked about, I'm in on that one, and great work behind the scenes. The minority parties are getting together, and we're going for Dan. But don't forget, it's not just Dan. The Liberal Party and the Labor Party working together mercilessly on this and the other parties. It's one big party, and we're going to spoil it, aren't we?
Yes, and if it wasn't for Dan, they would just replace him with somebody else if he wasn't towing that line. This has been planned years out in advance.